Good morning, children.
Good morning, ma'am.
Today, children, we are going to discuss about natural resources. Natural resources are very important for all the living beings. We all know that. Now, can you tell me all the things which are present around you, in your surrounding?
Plants.
Plants?
Air.
Air, yes.
Water.
Water.
Birds.
Birds. Trees. Trees, yes.
Buildings.
That's fine. So we have variety of things which are around us. Can we go back in our memory lane from the chemistry lesson and find out what these things, all these things are made up of?
Matter.
Elements and compounds.
Elements and compounds, are they made up of matter?
Yes.
Or matter is made up of elements and matter is made up of
elements and compounds.
Now I want to know, when you have identified all these things which are around you as matter, do you think all these things, the plants, air, water, animals, birds, are they also made up of elements and compounds?
Yes.
They are. So what do we understand? The varieties of things which are around us, they are made from same set of elements. Am I right? And if they are made from the same set of elements, do they get exhausted if they are consumed?
Yes.
After some time?
Yes. Yes.
They get exhausted.
If you remember, in class 8, you have learned a physics principle.
The law of conservation of mass states that the mass cannot be created nor destroyed.
It can only be
transformed.
Now, one of you said that the elements and the matter gets exhausted, but if it gets exhausted, then the law fails. According to law, how do we help, or maybe how does on the earth all the elements and compound remain constant?
By changing its form.
By changing its form. Can you give me one example?
Ma'am, oxygen, which is a part of the atmosphere, when we inhale, it becomes a part of our body, and then it is changed into compounds and elements.
Very good. That means you say that the compounds and elements present in nature, they are transformed, they keep changing their form from time to time. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
To understand it better, we will have a role play where you all will be performing one task. This activity is basically a role play. Each one of the child will pick up a sheet, and each of the sheet represents either a product or a process of carbon cycle.
I am carbon present as CO2 in the atmosphere. My concentration in the atmosphere is 0.03%.
I am plants. In the process of photosynthesis, I take carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and manufacture food.
I am animal. I consume plant products as my food and carbon enters my body.
During the process of respiration, plants and animals respire and they release the carbon dioxide again in the atmosphere.
Once they position themselves, they will know what their role is in the carbon cycle. These information about their role, they have already studied in junior classes, so it won't be difficult for them to speak. And children, those who are observing, will be able to connect and see how carbon moves in the nature.
I found this movement of carbon very interesting. Like, the first carbon dioxide was in the atmosphere, then it is consumed by plants by the process of photosynthesis. Then animals take this carbon as food, and when they respire, the carbon is released back to the atmosphere in the form of carbon dioxide.
In the second cycle, I am added as a decomposition. In this process, plants and animals die and they get decomposed, and CO2 is released in the atmosphere.
I am carbon present as CO2 in the atmosphere.
I am rain. CO2 in the atmosphere is dissolved in me and flows down into water bodies.
I am aquatic plant. I use CO2 to manufacture food during photosynthesis.
I am an aquatic animal and I consume plant products as food and carbon enters my body.
I am respiration. When aquatic plants and animals respire, they release carbon dioxide into the atmosphere.
Now you have seen movement of carbon in the various cycles operating in nature. The carbon which started from the atmosphere has passed through many stages and gone back to the atmosphere. It has changed its forms, but neither it was destroyed nor it was created. Does it satisfy the condition of law of conservation of mass which you have studied in physics?
Yes, ma'am.
Similarly, in the next class, we are going to see movement of nitrogen in nature. All the best to you, children.